village that have been asked to participate. I will be reading from Sherman Alexie's 10 Little Indians, a short story called Do Not Go Gentle. The story is actually about parents dealing with the grief of watching their son in a coma at the children's hospital. So I'll be starting soon after the narrator listens in on a conversation between two other fathers and how they trash talk another parent for letting herself go physically, visually, and they feel that parents should never let themselves go. Feeling disgusted from what he hears, he decides he's going to do something about it for himself. I felt like a good woman, and I wanted to be a good mother man. So I left the hospital and went out shopping for baby toys. The hospital was on 15th and John, and over the past few days on my journey between home and hospital, I've been driving past a toy store on Pike and 7th. It was called Toys and Babeland, and that was a cute name. So I figured I'd buy some stuffed teddy bears and a rattle and maybe some of those black and white toys the experts say are good for babies' eyes. Those seemed like good toy ideas, but I wasn't sure. What kind of toys do you buy exactly for a coma baby? I walked over to the store and strolled in, feeling quite religious about my mission, and was shocked myself to discover Toys in Babeland was a sex toy store. Honey, I said to my wife later, those women were selling vibrators and dildos and edible underwear and butt plugs and lubricants and some stuff. I had no idea what the hell you were supposed to do with it. Sweetheart, I said to her, some of those sex toys look like a genius and a crazy scientist made them. Now, I was surely embarrassed, but I'm not a prude, so I browsed around, not expecting to buy anything, but not wanting to run out of the store like a frightened Christian. Then I turned a corner and saw it, the vibrator they called Chocolate Thunder. Darling, I said to my wife later, I heard that big old music from that 2001 Space Odyssey movie when I saw that miracle vibrator. Chocolate Thunder was a dark brown and 15 inches long and needed a 9-volt battery. I like to think my indigenous penis is powerful, but it would take a whole war party of Indian men to equal up to one Chocolate Thunder. I was shy, but quick to buy the thing and ran back to the hospital with it. I ran into the fourth floor ICU, pulled Chocolate Thunder out of his box and held it up in the air like a magic wand and switched it on. Of course, all the doctors and nurses and mothers and fathers were half stunned by that vibrator. And it was a strange and difficult thing. It was sex that made our dying babies, and here was a huge old piece of buzzing sex I was trying to cast spells with. I waved it over our baby and ran around the room waving it over the other sick babies. I was laughing and hooting, and other folks were laughing and hooting, and a few others didn't know what the hell to do. But pretty soon, everybody was taking their turn casting spells with Chocolate Thunder. And maybe it was blasphemous, and maybe it was stupid and useless, but we were all sick and tired of waiting for our babies to die. We wanted our babies to live, and we were ready to try anything to help them live. Maybe some people can get by with quiet prayers, but I wanted to shout and scream and vibrate, and so did plenty of other fathers and mothers in that sick room. It was my wife who grabbed Chocolate Thunder and used it like a drumstick to pound her hand drum. She sang a brand new song that echoed up and down the hallways of Children's Hospital. Every sick and dying and alive and dead kid heard it, and they were happy and good in their hearts. My wife sang the most beautiful song anybody ever heard in that place. She sang like 10,000 Indian grandmothers rolled up into one mother. All the while, Chocolate Thunder sang with her and turned the whole thing into a healing duet. We humans are too simple-minded. We like to think each person, place, or thing isn't only itself. A vibrator is a vibrator is a vibrator, right? But that's not true at all. Everything is stuffed to the brim with ideas and love and hope and magic and dreams. I brought Chocolate Thunder back to the hospital, but it was my magical and faithful wife who truly believed it was going to bring our baby back to us. She wanted to bring every baby back to life. Over the next week, my wife sat beside our baby's bed and held that vibrator in her two hands and sang and prayed along with his buzzing. She used up the energy of two batteries, and maybe our baby would have woken up anyway, and a few other babies never did wake up at all. But my wife still believes our son heard the magic call of Chocolate Thunder and couldn't resist it. Our beautiful, beautiful boy opened his eyes and smiled, even if he was too young to smile. But I think sick kids get old and wise and funny very fast. And so my wife and I named him Abraham and carried him home and laid him in his crib and hung Chocolate Thunder from the ceiling above him like a crazy mobile and laughed with the joy of it. We deported Mr. Reef back to his awful country. Our baby boy was going to live a long and good life. We wondered aloud what we would tell Abraham about the wondrous world when he was old enough to wonder about it. So, as Naomi said, I am an educator. Last year I was teaching fourth graders and third graders the art of poetry. When you interact with them, sometimes you forget that some of the stuff they're dealing outside of the home. So one Monday morning, as they were coming in, asked one of the students how her weekend was. And this is inspired by her response. It's called Carnaval. And we went to the carnival, but not for the monkeys or the clowns or the food. We went there for the rides, like the one you get in and you sit and they tie you up, you know, where you go up slowly, 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 really, really high, and then they drop you really, really fast and you feel like you want to throw up. Yeah, it's that good. Or the mirror one, where there's mirrors like everywhere and you get lost and you look funny and weird like a twisted red line. And there, you know, I walked into a mirror, I didn't see, and that's how I got this. See, maybe you can't see it as much anymore, but I can see it right there, see. Well then, we were like putting ice on it, and these cops came over, and we're talking to my uncle, and then they took out the what they're called? The esposas. Yes, those. And then they took him because he didn't have like an ID or something, and they wouldn't let him go, and everybody was looking at him. And my uncle kept telling him he didn't care anything of him, and I was crying in them. And then they let him go, and we went home. Yeah, we went home. Thank you. Mm.